سيدنا أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
الحمد لله كثيرا سبحان الله بكرة واصيلا لا إله إلا الله وحده صدق وعده ونصر عبده وعز وعزم الأحزاب وحده لا إله إلا الله ولا نعبد إلا إياه مخلصين له الدين ولو كره الكافرون. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد وعلى أصحاب سيدنا محمد وعلى أنصار سيدنا محمد وعلى أزواج سيدنا محمد وعلى ذرية سيدنا محمد وسلم تسليما كثيرا.
نشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، لا شريك له في عزه ومجده، الذي بين به
ذلك من المنكرات. عباد الله، فلا تنقضوا ما غزلتم فتكونوا كالذين قال الله سبحانه وتعالى عنهم كالتي نقضت غزلها من بعد قوة أنكاثا. صدق الله العظيم. فاتقوا الله عباد الله وحافظوا على ما عملتم من الأعمال الصالحة وتوبوا إلى الله من تقصيركم وخطاياكم فإن الله تعالى يتوب على من تاب. نسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يتوب علينا جميعا. اللهم تب علينا جميعا، اللهم علينا جميعا. الحمد لله رب العالمين. We give the due thanks to Almighty Allah. We express our thanks to Him, our Lord, our Creator, our one who has been providing our needs, our sustainer, our benefactor, one who's behind our livelihood, our living, our living up to the moment. We pray, we ask Him to accept this gratitude from each and every one of us. We have nothing to say at this point in time rather than to be filled with gratitude for Him, rather than to show our delight over the successful completion of that obligation of Almighty Allah. When you are able to complete a particular assignment Allah has given unto you. What behoves you at that point in time is to be grateful and to be thankful. Here we are today at this hour, men, women, young, old, we are expressing our gratitude to Almighty Allah. We ask Him to accept the gratitude from us. And we should be rest assured that at the same time we are expressing these thanks, that if Almighty Allah has accepted it, honestly, we should be expecting more and more of His blessings. We should be expecting more and more of His benefits. We should be expecting more and more of His favors. May Almighty Allah continue to have more and more of earthly and heavenly favors on each and every one of us. We fervently believe in Him. We bear witness that none deserves devotions of man from time to time except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We equally bear witness that our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent to the entire mankind, وَمَا أَرْسَلْنَاكَ إِلَّا رَحْمَةً لِلْعَالَمِينَ, He sent him at the hand of all the previous prophets. He came to crown up the success meant for all of them previously. The Almighty Allah continue to have more and more of His blessings, of His benedictions on this beloved servant of Allah, on our beloved master, our beloved most admired leader, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The benediction of Almighty Allah, we ask Him to extend it to cover the entire household members of Prophet Muhammad. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to consider the totality of companions for these blessings spoken for our beloved Prophet Muhammad. I want to quickly say congratulations to all my brothers and sisters who have gone through that month, a whole month training course, one that is meant to give us self-denial when it comes to perpetrating evil. You should be able to learn how to deny yourself from following your whims and your volitions. The month training course that we have gone through, which has taught us effectively how to restrain ourselves from following our wishes. Instead of doing that, we prefer subjecting and subduing ourselves, surrendering ourselves and subjugating ourselves totally to the commandment of Almighty Allah. And what is that commandment? Ya ayyuhalladhina amanu kutiba alaykumus-siyam kama kutiba 'alal ladhina min qablikum la'allakum tattaqun. Allah was commanding us in that month that you should stay away from food and drink, from sexual intercourse, from some other frivolities, and obscene language, use of obscene language, and some other things that are capable of rendering your fast null and void. And we are able to scale through all those ordinances, all those commandments, and the prohibitions inclusive. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. May Almighty Allah answer our prayers and supplications. May Almighty Allah accept all our devotions, all the obligations of Almighty Allah that we observed during the month. May Almighty Allah, who promised in His scripture that whoever observes fasting during the month of Ramadan, let him be expecting two joys coming his way. One of the two joys is the one he is going to be having every evening time during the sunset. You know, when it is time for breaking of fast, we are always very joyful, happy that fasting of that day has been successfully observed. And the other joy that is awaiting us is the admittance into paradise through the Babu Rayyan, which Almighty Allah promised. We pray to Almighty Allah not to deprive us the fulfillment of that is promised. Let us say Ameen. Ibadallah, when we talk of Islam, Islam is not a religion that is only to be practiced during the month of Ramadan alone, my brother. Almighty Allah says in the Quran, Inna iddata shuhuri inda Allah isna ashara shahran. The total number of months constituting a year, the total number is 12 months. So therefore,
A year is not a year when you have not counted the number of months up to 12. It's just only one out of the 12 that we call Ramadan. And Allah who created us and said in the Holy Quran, wa ma khalaqtu al-jinna illa liya'budu. Wa ma khalaqtu al-jinna wal insa illa liya'budu. I have not created you, both you, jinn, and the mankind on the surface of the earth, but for the purpose of my worship. That we have done during the month of Ramadan. And there are so many other forms of worship that we should be doing on a daily basis. Ibadallah, let us not forget our daily obligatory prayers as at the time due on a daily basis. Now, you can be called a full-fledged Muslim. When it is only once a year like this, you subdue to Allah, you are yet to bona fide Muslim. The Almighty Allah categorize everyone from among Muslims hereafter. Father, we must have learned a lot of lesson. And fellow human beings are born in relationship. Either they are Muslims like us. Each and every very harmonious relationship with fellow human beings. Muslims, we must be ambassadors of all the dictates and commandments of our faith. And Islam is not a religion that is contrary or contradictory to peace. It is a religion that is given the name peace by Allah. It is a religion that we expect all the adherents, whoever that will be practicing the religion, to be so peaceful. Peaceful within himself, peaceful with his fellow man, peaceful with Allah, his creator. A number of things are there in the town today, tarnishing image of Islam. Muslims should never be an instrument of anything that will tarnish the religion. The religion, with so many people today, they only read about it within the four corners of their room. There's nobody there preaching the religion to them. And after going through the reading about it, they come to the conclusion that I want to become a Muslim. Historical men of the past, including those we have, the contemporary ones, with us today, people who read about Islam, they have no choice than to be one, than to be Muslims. Please, Muslims, we must always try and put into use all the lessons we successfully learned during the month of Ramadan. For instance, when Almighty Allah was saying that you are not observing fasting, if it is only abstinence from food and drink that you are maintaining, you must as well run away from anything that has to do with falsehood. Falsehood in your utterances, falsehood in your practices, falsehood in your deeds and in your actions. You must run away from anything having to do with falsehood. Islam is contradictory to falsehood. Islam is contradictory to enmity. You must always maintain friendliness with fellow human beings. Ibadallah, let us show the best of Islam every now and then when we relate with fellow human beings. We have learned from this month that we must learn how to strengthen the bond of brotherhood within us. When I'm talking of brotherhood, I'm not talking of brotherhood having to do with Islam alone. All human beings living on the surface of the head, we are all brothers and sisters. Allah says in the Holy Quran, chapter 49, Ya ayyuhan nasu inna khalaqnakum min dhakarin wa untha waja'alnakum shu'uban wa qabaila lita'arafu inna akramakum 'indallahi atqakum. Conclusively, I want to say that this our borough, Sadak Borough, is one that has been doing its best to bring us together. And that is Islam. You can perceive, you can smell from the practice and the action of borough that we belong to here. That is our Sadak. Please, brothers and sisters, let's do our best to uplift the name of our Sodok borough. Let's do everything possible to make it the best of all the boroughs in England by coming together, becoming one brotherhood, by working together, standing by one another, and be of big support for one another. Maintain good relationship with your neighbors in your neighborhood. That is what Islam commands. And by the time we are able to do all of these, we become better Muslims on a daily basis. Islam teaches us that we must be very loyal to the constituted authority. Allah himself is a constituted authority. And those he has raised to the position, he has elevated to the position of leadership in our midst, wallahi, they are all constituted authority. When you do not obey them and their commandments, their constitutions, you are a rebel. That is as far as Islam is concerned. Allah says in the Holy Quran, إِنَّ اللَّهَ يَعْمُرُ بِالْعَدِلِ وَالْإِحْسَانِ وَإِيْتَاهِ ذِي الْقُرْبَى وَيَنْهَى عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ يَعِظُكُمْ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَذَكَّرُونَ. Conclusively, Almighty Allah says, take to these three things if you want to be a Muslim. Number one, al-adil, try and be very fair and just in your daily interactions with fellow man. Try and be very fair and try and be very good. Try and be very righteous in everything you be doing. Almighty Allah says in the contrary, وَيَنْهَا عَنِ الْفَحْشَاءِ وَالْمُنكَرِ وَالْبَغْيِ. Run away from all that Allah has prohibited for you, from all that Allah has forbidden for you. Run away from munkar, run away from baghi. That is rebellion. Don't be a rebel. Ya'idhukum la'allakum tadhakkarun. Allah says, yes, put across this admonition to you. Perhaps and perchance you take to them. May Almighty Allah count us among those that will subdue themselves for the admonition of Almighty Allah. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونشكره ونستعينه ونستغفره ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا محمدا عبده ورسوله هو الذي أمرنا بأن نكون مسلمين بأن نكون مسلمات ومن هو مسلم فلنسأل أنفسنا المسلم فينا هو من سلم نفسه ومن سلم نفسه لمشيئة ربه نسأله سبحانه وتعالى أن يجعلنا من الذين يسلمون أنفسهم لمشيئة خالقهم وربهم ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم واتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار. When we are able to fast 30 days or 29 days of Ramadan like this, Prophet of Allah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says in his hadith that try in this month, this new month of Shawwal, to add 6 more number of fasting days to the one you observe during the month of Ramadan. And that will make you to appear as somebody who has observed fasting for a whole month, a whole year in the sight of Allah. Please, brothers and sisters, as soon as we are able to do that, let's make sure and become determined that we are going to have 6 more number of days of fasting to the one we have observed before. ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم. ربنا إننا سمعنا مناديا ينادي للإيمان. أنا آمين بربك فآمنا. ربنا فاغفر لنا ذنوبنا وتغفر عنا سيئاتنا وتوفنا مع الأبرار. ربنا آتنا ما وعدتنا على رسلك ولا تخزنا يوم القيامة إنك لا تخلف الميعاد. اللهم ألطف بنا فإنك بنا بصير. ونبل لنا فإننا لا نحسن التدبير. وكلنا بك إليك وخذنا بك إليك. ولا تحجبنا عنك ولا تقطعنا بقاعته الذنوب. يا من هو غني عن التفصيل. يا من تيسير العصير عليه يسير. نشكو إليك ما لا يخفى عليك. يا الله يا أرحم الراحمين. أقول قول هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين والمسلمات من كل ذنب. فاستغفروه إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
وعليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته.